వీ హ్యాడ్ ఎ మల్టిపుల్ కాంపోనెంట్స్. సేల్స్ ఫోర్స్ వాళ్ళు మనకి చాలా కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఇచ్చారండి, లెట్స్ అస్యూమ్. సో వాట్ ఎవర్ వీ హ్యాడ్ ఇన్ క్లాసిక్, లెట్స్ టాక్ అబౌట్ క్లాసిక్. క్లాసిక్ వీ హ్యావ్ టూ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్. వన్ ఈజ్ స్టాండర్డ్ థింగ్స్ యాజ్ ఎ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ బాక్స్ అండ్ ద వన్ వీ ఆర్ బిల్డింగ్ యాజ్ ఎ కస్టమ్, రైట్? ద సేమ్ వే ఇన్ లైట్నింగ్ సేల్స్ ఫోర్స్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ సమ్ కాంపోనెంట్స్. Those components, the components which are provided by Salesforce, the components which are provided by Salesforce, they are called base components. Base components. So, if you ask me that, how can I know what the base components and what's their functionality? So, Salesforce will change it, just because of that reason, they also helped in a documentation, like here. This is the only URL I'm just pinging in chat for your reference. I'm just pinging you in the URL. If you can open, so you will be having all the components like Lightning, Aura, Force.com. Let's talk about only Lightning now. Let's say Lightning. If I wanted to know Lightning record form, there is a record form for us. Let's say, where is record form? Here, record view form. So now we had a clear documentation saying that how to use, what to use and all. Lightning record form is generally what to do? To view a record in a Lightning component with using Lightning data service. We have two types of data services. We have two types of data service. Lightning data service, or we can also have access using server calls from client controllers. This will go on JavaScript, which is a custom solution. Lightning data service is a standard data service provided by Salesforce, but server calls from client controller is a JavaScript concept, which is a custom solution. That one we will be defining. Clear on this? Are we clear on this? Lightning data service, standard data service, and server calls. Here, all lightning column by default, these are inherited Lightning data service. By default, all lightning base components are inherited Lightning data service. Are we good? Okay. So let me do one thing. I'm just creating one simple component. Saying that how to create a component. Open your developer console. File, new, Lightning component. Let's say account view. This is an example of record view form using Lightning data service. So let's consider accounts. Accounts, all accounts, let's say University of Azure. So I wanted to add my Lightning component in this page. Generally in Visual Force, what we'll do, if I want to add any Lightning component to any page, then what I need to do, I need to implement my standard controller, right?
Yes.
Here, we do not have any standard controller. Instead of standard controllers, we have a interfaces. What we have? Interfaces. I wanted to implement, because I wanted to add this component on a record page. So I need to implement my record page as a interface. I need to implement my record page. So I implemented my record page. Edit. So let's say I'm just keeping strong. I am lightning data service component. I'm just saved. So now here you can see what it is implemented. Flexi page available for record home. Record home is nothing but a detailed page of any record. Might be we are creating for account. You can also use the same thing for a properties, brokers, leads, wherever you want you can keep. There is no issue with a lightning component development. Clear on this?
Yes.
Okay.
Clear.
Then we also have, let's say I implemented my component. How component will know on which record I am there? How component will get to know in which record I am executing? How it will know whether it is using University of Azure, Arizona, or United Oil Gas, whatever. For that, what it is implemented? Another ID called force colon has record ID. So for all record home pages, if the component is running, it means they will be having ID of a record, Salesforce ID for sure, right or wrong? That ID will get inherited by default from a Salesforce. You don't want to handle whatever record you open as a parent record, whatever ID you have in URL, it will inherit in a has record ID. So it means the component, the place where you are loading, it actually have a ID of that component, right? So let's say now I wanted to add my component. How to add my component? I wanted to edit a page. This is not a detail page. This is a app builder page. What page is this? App builder page. If I want to modify anything, I need to modify at a app builder page, edit page. Here you have a top, you can see. Here you have a setting symbol, right? Here you have a edit page. Once you click on edit, it will open a app launcher, lightning app builder. You can see lightning app builder, right? So whatever you want to add, you can add drag and drop. Here you can see right side account view is my component. All I need to have a drag and drop the place where the way we had custom fields to a page layout, as same as that. Now I save. First you need to activate assign as a org level. We'll discuss more what and all we have. By default, make as a assign as a org level for now. Going forward, we'll see what is what, how many ways you can assign one app builder page to different profiles, record types, and all this stuff. So I added my I am Lightning Data Service component. Yes, I am added, right? Okay, now I'll go. So here we have what record we have? We have record view form. Ensure, guys, we need to buy hard this. No matter what, we need to buy hard. So you don't want to buy hard actually. All you need to keep this library open for you always. Developer.salesforce.com docs complement. I shared this URL. For now, you need to open this URL and ensure that you have to go through. Whether you are implementing or not implementing, at least you should have an idea what type of tags we have. We have one Lightning Data Service tag to view our data is called Lightning Record View, which is a new feature released on Winter 18. So all I need to have Lightning Record. What it is expecting? It is expecting the record ID and then object API name. What it is expecting? Record ID and object API name, right? So what is my record ID here? Let's say I'm just using this. I'm not retyping. What is our object API here? Account, right? Yes or no? Okay, what is record ID? How to get a record ID now? How to get a record ID?
Open the record.
Account.id.
Which will not gonna work. Which will not gonna work. Let me comment out this line of code. We'll discuss how to get a record ID first. To get a record ID, we have two concepts. Default tags, data tags in page. In component is v.body, which is a default tag which will load in the component body. And another one we have v.recordID. If hasRecordID is implemented, v.recordID will get your ID. It's not account.id, it's a v.recordID. Why it is a v dot? Because these are component attributes. These are component attributes. All component attributes were inherited through v dot. So now all I need to pass this v dot. Let's say I saved this. I'm just refreshing. I need to get my account ID here. That was my expectation. Do I have an account ID? Do I have account ID now?
Yes,
I have account ID. Let's say I'm just removing this stuff. Now I'm passing my record ID. Say, oh sorry, the space is not. Now I'm just refreshing. Now what I need to get? I need to get my name. Do I have account name?
Yes, we have.
Okay, let's say, does Salesforce is a case sensitive?
No.
But, yes, Classic have no case sensitive, but Lightning, it's a case sensitive. Lightning is a case sensitive. Now you can see you don't get anything. The reason behind, in account object, what is the syntax? What is the name, API name for an account? Name. It's not name, capital N. It's a capital N. It's not a normal name. It's a capital N. Clear? Let me say, now I am removing my object API. What happens? I removed my object API. What happens? Do I get my output? Is it? We'll see. What happened? Here, object API is not mandatory. Object API is not an mandatory. Now you can see, still you can able to see. If I implemented object API, now let's say I'm going on properties page. I'll add the same component even in properties. Let's say I'm editing page. I can drag and drop, right? Because why I can able to drag and drop this component? Because it is in implemented interface called available for all flexi pages as a record home. Yes or no? Because of that implementation, we can able to add wherever we need it. Save.
But here the field API names are different, right?
But any object API name is same, right? For now I am showing
yes,
only name.
Okay.
So name exists, right?
Yes.
Let's say I have a field like, let's say I have one custom field. In account I have what field? Parent ID, right? Parent ID. I'm just refreshing. So parent ID, which is available in account, which is not available in properties. Now I'm refreshing. So ideally you are thinking you should get an error. Anyway, here we don't have a, I think we don't have this one, details. Let me edit this. Let me populate one University of Azara. Oh, I can't do this. UN accounts. United Island Gas. Save. Now you got United Island Gas, comma Singapore. So parent account ID is coming up. Yes or no? Now let's say refresh. Here you will be saying that it will throw error. But actually it will get only those fields which are available for this page. You can refer all fields, but it will only consider the fields which are available for this object with a has record ID notation. Clear? So whatever ID you are, let's say instead of doing that, I'm copying this. I'm hard coding my record ID. Record ID is a properties. Object API name is account. Now what will be the output in account? Do I have an account name and parent account will get? It will not. It will get only the property name, SWAT8 Brattle. Because the main parameter for this record view form is record ID. Whatever ID you are passing, that will be considered as a object fields, right? Clear on this? Clear on this, guys? Yeah. Why we had a record ID here? What record ID is doing? Why we had record ID? Why we are using this record ID? And what exactly it is helping us?
Getting the record details.
How it is getting? Let's say I am removing has. I am removing this interface.
It won't work.
It won't work. Why it won't work?
Based on has record ID only. Component will get the ID.
So it means if we want to read a record parameter, you need to implement which implementation? Has record ID implementation. Is this a standard or a custom?
Standard.
So all implementations, the one we had, everything is a standard implementation. So are we good on this? What is v.record ID? And what is record view form? Is there any issue if you refer a wrong field? No.
No issue.
It will only consider which are related to that record ID. Can we reuse this component wherever we need it? Yes or no?
Yeah, yes.
We can reuse or not?
We can reuse.
Yes, we can.
Good. Any doubt?
No.